The Graphic Repeater OMI app can be used to visualize any data using industrial graphics. If the data can be represented in a table format, the app is perfect for visualizing it. As an example, let's consider this table that has a number of regions. It also has the population numbers for those regions. It also has a number of additional columns or fields for things like rainfall, temperatures, and areas. Now, industrial graphics can be designed to have a number of custom properties. For instance, it can have a rainfall property and also have a number of other properties, and these properties are used to animate the graphic. Now, the Graphic Repeater app will allow you to go and specify which of these custom properties should be used and are present in your table, and the app will then repeat this graphic for every row record in the table, and each graphic will be animated or visualized to the corresponding data in that row. Okay, let's go and have a look at how that works. In the layout editor, you can find the Graphic Repeater app in the toolbox. Simply drag it onto a pane where you want it, and then configure it by going to the Properties tab. Now, first of all, you've got to specify the name of the graphic you want to repeat. We're going to use a simple bar. The height gets animated based on two custom properties, label and value. We want to use them both, so we specify to the app that we want to use label, comma, value. That's the format of the data stream now as well. And we can add records by going label, comma, value. We can add the values as constants, or we can use references to things like tag name and alias name. For the value, I'm using the region's levels. I can then tell the app to sort by the label, and we can tell it to sort ascending. And then we can specify that we want to see it in a horizontal list. So let's go and have a look what that looks like. We see our four graphics are repeated. They all have live values, and they are sorted alphabetically by label. Let's go back to the app's configuration and make it a bit more interesting. We can add a background graphic. So if you have a graphic that has a little bit of a plot area and maybe some axes and a heading, you can add that as a background. We can filter on the top n value. So I'm changing it to 2. We'll only show 2 graphics. Change the sorting to value. We're going to change it to live sorting. And we add a little bit of a buffer on the side so we only plot inside our plot area. And that's what it looks like in runtime. You can see it now plots only in the plot area. We can also change the data to be a reference instead of a constant and point it to an attribute somewhere in my galaxy. In this case, I'm pointing it to a view app namespace attribute that has all 50 states and their levels configured, so we can see them all showing up in the graphic. The app is also responsive, so if you resize it, the content will change based on the size of the app. And you can use any graphic you want to with a Graphic Repeater app. For instance, on the left there, I have a vertical list of tanks coming from the symbol library. You can also display your graphics in a grid format by specifying rows and columns. And you can interact with these graphics. So on the right here, I create a set of bars which I can interact with. I can click on them and it opens up a faceplate, which allows me to go and simulate some alarms. And even the background graphic can be dynamic. So this background graphic here has a dynamically changing axis built into it. And data can come from anywhere. For instance, here I have an alarm app. Currently has 2 alarms in it, and I can see 2 graphics popping up corresponding to the 2 alarms. So if I go back to my system and create a couple of extra alarms, we can see as the alarms start popping up in the alarm app, the corresponding graphic starts popping up in the Graphic Repeater app below that. The data can also be sourced from outside. So if I have a SQL table, like this one I have here with the rainfall and population, etc., I can also have that populate the Graphic Repeater app and fill in the graphics with that data for me. I can also use it for things like monitoring my app engine, scan times, etc. This is a really, really versatile app, and we hope you're going to enjoy it. Thank you for joining us.